Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I want to share with you how I pack minimally for a weekend of travel. Just a few years ago, I would pack multiple large bags for an overnight trip, but now I'm able to easily pack for an entire long weekend in a small backpack. So today I want to share what and how I pack for shorter term trips to hopefully give you some inspiration on how you might be able to pack more lightly when traveling. And of course, hopefully this goes without saying, but obviously we're in the midst of COVID-19 right now, so please be sure to abide by any state or national travel restrictions that might be in place. But with that in mind, this is how I pack minimally for shorter term travel. Let's start off with electronics. During this trip, I am going to be doing some work, including some video editing, so I am going to need my laptop. This is the 2018 MacBook Pro, and it slots really easily into the laptop sleeve in this backpack. Especially when traveling, I like to keep all of my electronic cords in one case, so I like to use this little pineapple canvas bag that I got in Hawaii last year to just store all of those. So looking quickly in here, I have an adapter for my MacBook Pro, I have my AirPods so I can listen to music while traveling, I have the charging cord for my laptop, and the charging cord for my phone. And obviously I'll bring my phone as well. All those cords fit easily into this bag, and it's just a nice compact way of being able to store all my cords so they don't make a mess in my bag when traveling. Let's look at clothing next. I have two tank tops that I'm going to be bringing with me. I like to roll them so that they take up less space in the backpack. And this first tank that I'll be bringing is an Everlane button down black linen tank top. It's extremely comfortable and perfect for the hot summer weather we're experiencing currently. And then the second white woven tank top is from the brand Twofold Clothing, which is local here in Charlotte. They're an amazing ethical and sustainable brand, and one that I really love. And then as far as bottoms goes, I'll show you the outfit that I'll be traveling in a minute. But other than that, I'll be bringing a pair of pajama bottoms for sleeping in, as well as this pair of high-waisted Everlane skinny jeans. They'll give me an additional option of something to wear if it's cooler in the evening, as well as just an opportunity to switch it up so I'm not wearing the same pair of shorts each day. And then for undergarments, I'm just going to be bringing a couple pairs of underwear and my favorite organic basics bralette. Let's talk about toiletries next. In here, I keep my entire makeup collection, which I'm not going to walk through for the sake of this video, but in the cards up above and in the description box, I'll have linked to that video if you're interested in what's in my makeup collection. But I typically keep all of my makeup in this bag, which has plenty of space in it, so that when I'm traveling, I can always add extra items to it. So to that makeup bag, I'm going to be adding my deodorant, my favorite moisturizer right now, which is from the brand Nuori, as well as a little bit of coconut oil so I can remove my eye makeup at night. All of those items fit in there with plenty of space, so to that I'm just going to add a couple more items, my wooden brush and my scrunchie. So that easily packs up, and it's a nice compact way of being able to travel with toiletries. But then a couple other items that didn't fit in there that I'll also be bringing are my shampoo and conditioner and toothbrush. And then we're down to the final few miscellaneous items here. First off, I'm also going to be bringing my planner and a pen. I organize my entire life on this thing, so I never travel without it. I'm also going to be bringing my little wristlet, which serves as both a purse and a wallet when traveling. And of course, I'll be bringing my reusable water bottle, which I never leave the house without. And then finally, into that front pocket, I'm going to be sliding a couple of cloth masks. I don't plan on being out in public much during this trip, but it's always good to have them on hand just in case. And then the last thing here is to grab my keys, and we're good to go. And all of that fits nicely into this little black backpack from ISM. This is a backpack I've had for a few years now, and I love that it's not only beautiful, but very functionally designed. It has padded straps, so it's really comfortable to wear, and it's something that I have really gotten a lot of use from in the past few years. All right, well, I'm about ready to head out the door. With today being day one of the trip, I'll also show you what I'm wearing. For my top, I'm going to be wearing this striped t-shirt from the brand Madewell. It's incredibly comfortable, and as such, great for traveling. And then for my bottoms, I'm going to be wearing this vintage pair of Levi's shorts. They're very worn in, as well as a bit oversized, which once again makes them extremely comfortable. And then the only shoes I'll be bringing on this trip are the ones I'll be wearing. This is a pair of woven mules from the brand Nisolo, and I love wearing mules, especially when traveling, because they're very easy to slip on and slip off, which is really helpful, especially if you're doing a lot of traveling in the car, like we're going to. All right, well, that is what I pack and my process for packing for shorter term travel. I hope this video gave you some ideas and inspiration on how you might be able to get away with less, especially when traveling. If you are interested in anything that I mentioned during this video, I'll try to leave everything linked up in the description box below. And if you enjoyed this video and you're here here for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button below for more simple and intentional living content coming at you twice a week. But that is everything I have for you today. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.